Praise the Lord. Glory be to God. We bless the name of the Lord. We give him praise. We give him glory. We give him honor. We give him adoration. King of kings, King of glory, Lord of hosts. The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. The Lord Jesus, who has never lost anyone before. We celebrate your majesty, God of all grace and glory. Glory be to your holy name. Thank you, dear Lord Jesus, for the gift of life, for counting us worthy to be alive. We celebrate you, dear Lord Jesus. We worship you. We honor you. We thank you, dear Lord Jesus, for all our women, all our mothers, all over the world. We celebrate you. We worship you. We thank you for the gift of life. We thank you, Father. We celebrate you. We worship you. We honor you. Father, you are the God of all grace. We pray for more grace, great grace for all women, all mothers, all our sisters, all our wives, all over the world. Let your great grace abound. Let them experience multiplication of grace in every aspect of life. Glory be to your holy name. Good morning, Holy Spirit. God of all grace, for the next few minutes, do what is in your plan. Let your holy name be glorified in the mighty name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Amen. We shall now when I ready Jesus Christ to be moved. Now may worship may wish him in a happy Mother's Day. We wish him in a happy Mother's Day. Say a wedding and coupon on share your mammy munina. Mammy George and also table and coupon on share and wanting a new chill when I ready Jesus Christ to be moved. Oh, I do be brave and musuman when I ready Jesus Christ to be moved. Ya mami Emilia Newman Yankopon Adom Emusu Mount. Ya mami Joyce Tulasi, former general secretary's wife. Yankopon Ontine Nimichiro, now normal whenever Jesus Christ to Dim. Ya mami Juan Jamfi, former chairman of Better Prayer Ministry International's wife. And Yankopon Ontine Nimichiro, Norman Adom Nimichira, and Yakasil. Ya mami Lumina, Yankopon Shira, ya mami comfort from Paul. Nyankopo on shiraw, non tine ni mchiraw. Ya mame, mumu nina, mwo gana, mwo yasya fane nina, o nyankopo on tine ni mchiraw, non non mo. Me nana, Kate Asamoa, enra yo birthday, yetu birthday na mune ewan, yereba bediwe Yesu dimu. Nyankopo on shiraw, anti Kate, non tine ni mchiraw, nerewe di Yesu Christo dimu. Mama Jay, nyame mkonkron, mama, nyankopo on shiraw, babi ya drum diya yam Bible, na, ube humi, wenerewe di Yesu Christo dimu. Nyankopon tine ni mchila wana ready Yesu Christo ntimu. Hallelujah. Nyankopon shira mwenye na on tine ni mchila mama Monique. Ya mami, mawe fwa. Nyankopon tine ni mchila wana ready Yesu Christo ntimu. Me mami Joyce. Joyce. Mese Joyce Akuria. Nyankopon tine ni mchila auntie Joyce. Nyankopon shira na on normal wana ready Yesu Christo ntimu. Me mami nana ya frimpon. Nyankopon ma nyankopon shira sister. Nana ya sana ya fro. Hallelujah. Nyankopon shira ye sister. Nana ya nyankopon shira no tine ni mchira na onno. Ye maame no nyina ye nua ba no nyina nyankopon shira na ontine ni mchira. Na me mam ye firi me ankasa my beloved wife. Hallelujah. My wife nyankopon shira. See nyankopon shira. My queen nyankopon shira na ontine ni mchira. No onno. Me pa bo ni se onyankopon adom ye me kan nyina ni se ye be bom pa yanse na me be to aso ye be bom pa specific and baby biara wo wo bom pa ya ma ma me se already nyankopon ma adom wo ya adom nyina nyankopon mo adom emra me ma me so wo bom pa ya ma ma me wo anti bi wo nua bi ya wo aboa wo ma me ye nua no ma na o mo bre papa papa pa o mo go through so many challenges, so many difficulties. Ye ma me no ma bre wo ye ho pa ye anti no ma bre ye ho pa ye nua ma pa info bre ye ho pa ye mo pa ye mo se already sure no anti ne nchom na mi mami ye free mi na na kwia dey nyankopon o shira ene na na fa te nyankopon shira na na kwia dey a o nyankopon shira no anti ne nimi chira o ma nkwatenten ne apo dey na nkoso ala ntinase by the grace of God we do over 100 years na nyankopon shira no aye ne kese na ne bi hu o me na na ehu ne se o yo bia o do nyankopon o do nyankopon pa mo amu nim no mo matena wanchi da even the church of Pentecost omo sha ase o Pentecost e wo manchi no ono na accommodate all pastors omo ba the whole omo ba area no anas mo ba manchi district inti nyankopon shira na na enye mo ntimi nua ba me nua be ma
ese se
ya me ne pri na ye yo nyakopo adwuma ye na ni hira na atom e be ye kese wo ye so.
So on this floor we are going to pray for all mothers, all our aunties, our sisters, our wives, all women all over the world. The Father bless them. You are the God of all grace. Bless them, bless them, bless them to continue to be a blessing. In the name of the Lord Jesus, bless them in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Glory be to God. Without forgetting, our mother also, the General Secretary's wife, our current or the sitting General Secretary's wife. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Eye, ye mame, Apostle Linda, Boateng Srebom. Mama Linda, nyankupo ishira, no one tine ni michira opa. Glory be to God. Nyankupo ishira, unishira, no one nomo. Eni adumni nyansa, odo bua, eye papa, eye Apostle General. Glory be to his holy name. Eye General Secretary, Apostle Abel Boateng Srebom. Nyankupo ishira, munina, whenever yesu. So let's begin to pray for all our mothers, all our aunties, our sisters. Let's pray for them all, the God of all grace. Give them more grace in the name of the Lord. Let's pray for our mothers. Let's pray for our parents. Let's pray for them. The Father bless them. God of all grace, give them more grace, more grace, more grace, more grace, more grace, more grace to every woman, every lady, every female child. Father, bless them to continue to be a blessing. In the name of the Lord Jesus, Father, preserve their lives. Father, deliver them from every messenger of Satan. In the name of the Lord Jesus, Father, we commit our mothers unto their hands. We commit our wives unto their hands. We commit our sisters unto their hands. Father, you are the God of all grace. Give them more grace, multiplication of grace, overflowing grace. In the name of the Lord Jesus, and may the God of all grace lift up his countenance upon all our mothers, our women all over the world. And may the God of all grace give them more grace. Great grace, overflowing grace, and multiplication of grace. In the name of the Father, Son, and of the Holy Spirit. So shall it be in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Glory be to his holy name. Hallelujah. Amen. We are in the month of grace. The number 5 depicts, denotes grace. So we are here. Throughout this month, we will be talking about the grace of God. Grace. Grace. And this morning, I want us to reflect on the topic, the God of all grace. The God of all grace. The God of all grace. Not the God of some grace. No, not the God of partial or partly grace. But the God of all grace, the God of all grace, the God of all grace. Why all grace? You need to know that from context, not out of context. And we will discuss that briefly to the glory and honor of his holy name. Our God, his name is the God of all grace. One of his names is the God of God grace. Apart from knowing God to be called Jehovah Shammah, Jehovah Nissi, Jehovah Rapha, Jehovah Chikenu, Jehovah Elohim, glory be to God. We know him as well to be called the God of all grace. The God of all grace. The God of all grace. Not a God of all grace, but the God of all grace. Specific, definite, peculiar, specified. There is a specified that the God of all grace. May you experience the God of all grace. My brother, my sister, under the sound of my voice all over the world, all we need in life is that we need a God of all grace. In every aspect of life, from archaeology to zoology, we need the God of all grace. Glory be to God. When it comes to marital life, we need a God of academic, political, in every aspect of life, we need a God of all grace. We need a God of all grace. We need political grace, academic grace, religious grace, in every marital grace. Marital grace. Some of you need to get married, or some of you might have been married, but you are going through so many challenges, so many difficulties. It means you do not have the marital grace. We need academic grace, not to be barren academically, not to be barren maritally, not to be barren ministerially to be unfruitful. We need to be fruitful. But before you can enjoy all round fruitfulness, all round prosperity in Christ Jesus, you need a God of all grace. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. So let's turn our Bibles to 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 10. You get to know that our God is called the God of all grace. Hallelujah. Let's listen to the word of God. 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 10. But may the God of all grace, who called you, who called us to his eternal glory, who has called you to his eternal glory, the God of all grace. If for you to become a Christian, for you to come to the saving knowledge of the Lord Jesus, you need to experience the God of all grace. We need to experience the God of all grace. Now, may the God of all grace, who called us to his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after you have suffered a while, perfect, established, strengthened, and settled you. Glory be to God. When it comes to spiritual settlement, spiritual establishment, academic establishment, marital establishment, or marital settlement, we need to count on the God of all grace. Now, may the God of all grace, who called you, who called us, so who can call you, who can bring you to the saving knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus, the God of all grace. So what makes God, the question we have to ask ourselves is that, what makes God the God of all grace then? What makes him the God of all grace? It's simple. You can even read, when you talk about salvation, salvation is by grace. In every aspect of life, whatever you are going through in life, to make it in life, ministerially, academically, maritally, religiously, and every aspect of life, particularly in everything you do, it's all about the God of all grace. It's all about the God of all grace. Somebody may count on all sort of demonic things, witches and wizards, principalities and powers, occult powers. By the end of the day, if the God of all grace does not permit you, you will mount to nothing, you will go nowhere, it will be a fiasco, it will be a mirage, it will be a monumental fiasco. My brother, my sister, you need the God of all grace. You need the God of all grace. You need the God of all grace. We need the God of all grace. Glory be to his holy name. We need the God of all grace. Hallelujah. So you can read that from Ephesians chapter 2 verse 8. You get to know that salvation is by grace. Salvation is by grace. Living in holiness, in righteousness, in total purity is by grace. It's by grace. It's by grace. Living in holiness is by grace. Living in holiness is by grace. The word of God says, we should pursue peace with all men. And without holiness, no one shall see the Lord. Hebrews chapter 12 verse 14. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 14. Pursue peace and holiness with all men, and without which no one shall see the Lord. But for you to live in holiness and righteousness is by grace. We need to live in holiness and in righteousness. And the word of God says, 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 16, for it is written, be holy because I am holy. Is by grace. For you to become holy, for you to be righteous, for you to be pure in the sight of the Lord, we need the grace of God, my brother, my sister. To be a faithful minister of the gospel, you need the grace of God. To be a faithful politician, a loyal politician, a minister of the gospel, you need the grace of God. We need the grace of God. Glory be to his name. Serving God is by grace. Serving God is by grace. Serving God is by grace. If you can serve God acceptably, holy, in holiness, in righteousness, is by grace. It's by grace. We need to serve God. We're serving God is by grace. Hallelujah. You can read that from Hebrews chapter 12, verse 28. Therefore, since we are receiving a kingdom, Hebrews chapter 12, verse 28. Therefore, since we are receiving a kingdom, we cannot be shaken. Let us have grace. Let us have grace. You need grace. Let us have what? Grace. Let us have grace. Not let us have money. Not let us have mansions. My brother, my sister, let us have grace by which we may serve God acceptably with reverence and godly fear. Glory be to God. Without the grace of God, you cannot serve God acceptably. You cannot serve God acceptably. We cannot serve God acceptably. Let us receive grace. Receive grace to serve God acceptably, my brother, my sister, and the son of my wife. Receive grace to serve God, to embark on vigorous evangelistic program, to embark on kingdom promotion agenda, kingdom promotion, kingdom focus business. Receive grace to do so in the name of the Lord Jesus. To serve God acceptably is by grace. It's by grace. It's by grace. To live in holiness is by grace. To do the work of the ministry is by grace, my brother, my sister. And we need the grace of God in every aspect of life. Glory be to His holy name. In everything we do, we need the grace of God. We need the grace of God. We need the grace of God. In actual fact, repenting of your sin is by grace. God cannot repent you, but you need the grace of God to repent and come to the saving knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. God is commanding you to repent when you read Acts of the Apostles, chapter 17, verse 30. Acts of the Apostles, chapter 17, verse 30. The word of God says, in terms of ignorance, the Lord God Almighty winked at him. But now, He commands all men, all people, everywhere to repent. God is commanding you to repent. God is commanding you to repent, Mr. Politician. God is commanding you to repent, Mr. False Prophet. God is commanding you to repent, Mother False Prophetess. God is commanding you to repent, to repent, to repent, Mr. Occult Grandmaster. God is commanding you to repent, fornicator, lesbian, homosexual, drunkard. God is commanding you now to repent. God is commanding you now to repent. Receive grace to repent of your sins in the name of the Lord Jesus. We need grace to repent of our sins. Glory be to His holy name. Hallelujah. We need the grace of God to repent. Receiving the gift of the Holy Spirit is by grace. It's by grace. Living for God, the gift of God, is by grace. If you have any gift, it's by the grace of God you have it. Don't be selfish. Don't be self-seeking. Don't pursue personal interests or personal aggrandizement to the detriment of the masses or the church members. You need to repent of your sin and know that it's just by the grace of God that you can preach, you can witness. If I can preach, it's by the grace of God. If I can speak English, I can speak Greek, I can speak French, it's by the grace of God. If I can open my mouth even to say a word in any local language, it's by the grace of God. Somebody somewhere cannot even open their mouth. Somebody somewhere cannot even visit ladies or gents. Cannot even poop, my brother, my sister. Somebody cannot even take water, cannot drink water. It's by grace. Somebody cannot even breathe, my brother, my sister, if you are alive. So the word of God says, let everything that has breath praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. If you are alive, it's by the grace of God. And we thank God. That is why our God is called the God of all grace. That's why our God is called the God of all grace. We need the God of all grace in every aspect of life. We need the God of all grace in Ghana, the God of all grace in Africa, the God of all grace in our nations, the God of all grace in Europe, in Asia. My brother, my sister, don't tell me that we are religious, we claim we are Christian, but so many things are not going on because of our character, because of our behavior, because we don't do things in conformity with the word of God. We need to repent of our sins and come to the saving knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Glory be to His holy name. So in everything that you do to become an effective minister of the gospel, to become hardworking, diligent minister of the gospel, is by grace. It's by grace. It's by grace. It's by grace. Paul the Apostle said, I am what I am by the grace of God. Yet not I, by the grace of God, I labor more abundantly than them all. Yet not I, by the grace of God, by the grace of God, by the grace of God, for you to work hard, for you to work harder, for you to be diligent, for you to be efficient, for you to be effective in ministry, in everything that you do in life, is by grace. My brother, my sister, it's by grace. We need to count of God. In short, for you even to make it to heaven, to make it to heaven at the end of the day, it's by grace. It's by grace. It's by grace. It's by grace. What does Titus chapter 2, verse 11 to 13 says? Titus chapter 2, verse 11 to 13 says, the word of God saying, the grace of God that brings salvation has appeared to all men. The grace of God brings us salvation. Has appeared to all men. That grace teaches us to say no to ungodliness, worldly passion, as we live self-controlled, upright, and godly life in this present age, as we are waiting for the glorious appearing of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. The grace of God that brings salvation, that brings the grace of God brings us salvation, deliverance, healing, empowerment, glory, honor. And at the end of the day, the grace of God will lead you to where? Heaven. And that grace has appeared to all men. And that grace, that's what teaches us to say no to ungodliness, worldly passions, and to live self-control, upright, and godly lives in this present world, in this present age, as we are all waiting for the glorious appearing of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. My brother, my sister, and the son of my wife, for you to make it to heaven is by grace. It's by grace. It's by grace. For me to make it to heaven is by the grace of God. I shouldn't be self-righteous. I have to count on God for His grace. For His grace, for His grace, for His grace to serve Him, to continue living for Him in holiness and in righteousness. We need the grace of God. We need the grace of God to serve the Lord in whatever challenge, whatever difficulty that you are going through in life. We need the grace of God. We need the grace of God. We need the grace of God in everything you go through, times of challenges, difficulties, sorrow. We need the grace of God. In everything we do, we need the grace of God. In the wake of COVID-19, we need the grace of God. The grace of God. We need to count on God's grace. God's grace. God's grace. God's grace. All ministers, all men and women of God, we need to come together and seek the face of God for great grace, for multiplication of grace, for more grace, and for overflowing grace for our nations. And all leaders all over the world, particularly our political leaders, need to come to the saving knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And need to count on the God of all grace. So that the God of all grace, the God of all grace, will decree and declare total eradication, remover of COVID-19 in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We need to count on the God of all grace. That the God of all grace Himself will decree and declare this messenger of Satan called COVID-19, coronavirus, die and disappear in our nations. That we seem to depend on ourselves. A lot of us don't depend on the knowledge of God, the wisdom of God. You cannot make it, whoever you are. You can be Professor Emeritus. You can be a great scholar. You can be a great scientist. Whoever, what do you mean by science? Everything from archaeology to geology is in the Bible. Let's go back to the Bible. Let's go back to the Bible and count on the God of all grace. And stop misbehaving. Taking that, it's all about technology. Who brought technology? Who is the originator of ICT or computing or technology? Who is the originator of wisdom, knowledge? It's God. My brother, my sister, we need the God of all grace to do well in every aspect of life. In the name of the Lord Jesus, Wherever you are, if you don't know God, you don't know the God of all grace, you need to know Him right now. You need to come to the saving knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. If you want to be born again, pray that, Lord Jesus, have mercy on me. I know that I don't have the God of all grace to be my Lord, to be my Savior. I don't know Jesus to be my Lord and my Savior. Lord Jesus, have mercy on me. Have mercy on me. Today, I, Michael Owusu Tebere, I repent of my sins and I give you my spirit, I give you my soul, I give you my body. Dear Lord Jesus, have mercy on me. You need to pray that, dear Lord Jesus, have mercy on me, 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 have mercy on me. God of all grace, I need you in my life. I need you to live in holiness. I need you to enable me to serve you acceptably. God of all grace, I need you, I need you, I need you, I need you. God of all grace, help me so that I won't disappoint you all the days of my life. God of all grace, help me, help me, help me, so that at the end of the day, I will make it to heaven. You will not tell me, depart from me, you evildoer, I never knew you. My Father, my God, God of all grace, be merciful unto me, be gracious unto me, in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Glory be to His holy name. Hallelujah. Now I want you to pray. Now that you have given your life to the Lord Jesus, I want you to pray this prayer, that dear Lord Jesus, I have suffered enough. You are the God of all grace. Now, what is it? You have called us to our eternal glory, not eternal shame, disaster, calamity, disease, suffering. No, you have not called us to experience that, to shame. You have not called us to total dissipation, suffering, death, disaster, calamity. No, He has called us to eternal glory. But after we have suffered a while, He Himself will establish us, will settle us, will strengthen us, will fortify us, and will help us to become well-grounded, well-rooted, well-consolidated in Christ Jesus. So I want you to pray that, Father, now I've given my life to the Lord Jesus. I know you now. You are the God of all grace. I've suffered a while. I've suffered for some time. So, Father, let all my problems come to an end. This month of grace, God of all grace, let all my challenges, all my difficulties come to an end in the name of the Lord Jesus. God of all grace, let all my anxiety, my worries, my problems in life, challenges in life come to an end. In the name of the Lord Jesus, God of all grace, be gracious unto me. Be gracious unto our family. Be gracious unto your church. Be gracious unto our nations. Be gracious unto the whole world. God of all grace, be gracious. Be gracious, oh Lord. We pray and we decree and we declare total settlement, that in every challenge, every difficulty that we are going through, Father, settle that case for us. In the name of the Lord Jesus, you are the God of all grace. Father, show us your grace and mercy. Thank you, God of all grace. Thank you, God of all grace, that you have called us to your eternal glory in Christ Jesus our Lord. Glory be to your holy name. We love you. We worship you. We celebrate your majesty for the answered prayer. May the God of all grace give you all more grace in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. God bless you to continue to be a blessing. By the special grace of God, this is Better Prayer Ministry International, our virtual service. Wherever you are, you can locate, you can look for any of our branches all over the world and worship with us. In your life, it's never, never going to be the same. May the God of all grace give you all more grace and bless you to continue to be a blessing in the mighty name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And I invite you to worship with us, and your life is never going to be the same. God bless you to continue to be a blessing. In Jesus' name, goodbye.